people travel nowadays or why people kept on moving? Well, geographical factors like hills, mountains and seas play a natural barrier of any country. Himalayan mountain range in the north acted as a barrier between India and Central Asia. Similarly, Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean form a natural frontiers of Indian subcontinent. So, it was difficult to cross the boundaries, but those people come across from the boundaries also came to India and settled here. They did not only come, but they brought their culture. Sometimes they emerge India's culture in them. Thus, the movements of the people moves on cultural traditions. People have shared new ways of carving stones, composing stones, and even cooking food on several hundred years. How did India get its name? That we will see in this topic. Two of the words we often use for our country that are India and Bharat. Before to know that I would like to explain you that our land India is a vast and Asian country of the Asian continent. It came to be known by various names during the various periods of history. First, it was known as Aryavart. Aryavart means the land of Aryans. You would have listened this type of words while Ramayan series was playing during this pandemic COVID-19, right? Okay, so Aryavart means land of Aryans. In Vedic period, as Bharatvarsh, Bharat means the land of King Bharat in the epic period, okay? That we will discuss afterward. We will discuss this word, okay? Now see, but today Aryavart and Bharatvarsh, today it is known as India and Bharat. The India word is derived from the Indus Valley. Indus called Sanskrit. Indus called in Sanskrit. Okay, I will tell you on the map. See on this map, Iran and Greece. Can you see? Okay. The Iranians and the Greeks who came through the northwest about 2500 years ago. And they were familiar with the Indus River or the Indus. And the land, the east of the river was called India. The name Bharat was used for a group of people who lived in the northeast. And they were mentioned in the Rigveda. Rigveda is the earliest composition in Sanskrit near about 3500 years ago. Okay. So, Bharat. Bharat, how did it get its name? So, Bharat, King Bharat, was the legendary emperor of India. He was the son of Dushyant of Hastinapura. And he was the ancestor of Pandava. Bharat had conquered all the greater India and united it, and it was named after Bharatvarsh. Okay, so have you got how our India got its name India on the Indus River and Bharat on the King Bharat? Okay, now see, finding out about the past. There are several ways to finding out about the past. One is to read books what were written about long ago. These were manuscripts. Why? Because they were written by the hand. In Latin, manuscripts. Manu means hand. Okay. So these were usually written on the leaf of palms on the specially prepared bark known as a birch. These type of trees grow in the Himalayas. Over the years, many manuscripts were eaten away by the insects. Some were destroyed, but many have survived, and they often preserve in the temples and monasteries. Monasteries means a building by a monks living under the religious and vows promises. In Marathi we say mutt, right? These books tell the information about the currents of subjects like religious belief, the life of kings, medicines and science. Beside that, there were epics, plays, many of books were written in Sanskrit. In ancient language, the others were written in Prakrit. Prakrit means the language spoken by the ordinary people. It was also written in the Tamil language also. Hope this part of the lesson you have understood. The rest and the last part of the lesson, tomorrow we will see.